As the cost of Victoria's second wave soars, the federal government is trying to soften the blow, throwing a multi-billion dollar lifeline to hundreds and thousands of workers. Live to our political reporter, Jonathan Kersley in Canberra. And Jonathan, JobKeeper will be easier to access. What are the changes?
Ali, the Treasurer and Prime Minister have announced that beyond September, the so-called turnover test for businesses will change. So it will mean the companies won't have to prove their turnover losses over a six-month period. Instead, that will be just a three-month period to the end of September. It will mean essentially more businesses in Victoria affected by the latest shutdowns will become eligible for the wage subsidy. It is estimated to cost $15 billion because it's a national program. The changes apply across the country. The numbers of Victorians on JobKeeper will also soar from 970,000 to 1.5 million people. Here's the Treasurer. Increased restrictions have been estimated by Treasury to cost $7 to $9 billion and could put anywhere between 250 to 400,000 people out of work or cut their hours to zero. The crisis and the response, Ali, likely to dominate talks at National Cabinet today.
Sure will. Thanks, Jono.
Now, the Treasurer coming up live too. There's growing outrage in Melbourne this morning over an illegal anti-mask protest planned for the weekend. Today's Christine Ahern is covering the story in Melbourne for us. Chris, how many people are expected to take part if it does go ahead?
Carl, more than 400 people have expressed interest in attending this Freedom March, which vows to fight the lockdown. No more masks, no more fear. But it does remain to be seen how many people actually turn out here on Sunday morning. Police certainly have said they will crack down because it is a clear breach of the Chief Health Officer's orders and puts lives at risk. In a statement, police say that the selfish behaviour will absolutely not be tolerated. Be assured, Victoria Police will be responding and will take appropriate action. That action is on-the-spot fines of $1,600 and possible arrests. It comes as the Victorian Premier yesterday was placed under enormous pressure over his handling of the bungled hotel quarantine. It came a day after the judge leading the inquiry said there's absolutely no obstacles as to why the Premier and other ministers cannot answer questions about it. In a 90-media media conference, the Premier continued to dodge questions, but he did make this admission.
I'm accountable for any mistakes and all mistakes that are made. I will own those errors. I will be accountable for those errors.
And the state coroner has launched an investigation into the deaths of five residents at St Basil's Aged Care in Fawkner. The inquiry could lead to possible criminal charges and jail time for those in charge.
Oh, Carl. Boy. Christine Ahern, thank you.
Staying in Melbourne, and supermarkets have been given more leeway in the lockdown in a bid to stop people from panic buying. Isabella Staszkowski is at Paran in Melbourne. Good morning to you, Isa. An agreement has been reached with the state government.
Alex, good morning. Well, this is basically all around keeping supermarket shelves full. A deal has been struck to ensure that distribution centres can operate at full capacity. But it is a trade-off when it comes to staffing, so we're expecting to see a number of changes in store. For example, here at Woolworths, we're expecting that those who are over 70 or those who are vulnerable workers will be sent home for at least a six-week period. We are being told, though, that they will receive full pay. At least 1,300 Victorian staff members will have changes in their working conditions over this period. Now, the Premier had initially said that warehouses would have to operate at a 33% capacity, but when big business chiefs raised their concerns, these new rules came into effect late last night. Now, there were fears that these rules would lead to a national food supply shortage and panic buying, as you said, as well as aggression in stores. Hopefully this will work, but some suppliers are still worried that other restrictions will cause their supply chain to have issues as well. So now it is a waiting game, Alex, to see if these restrictions will be effective.
Hopefully it works, Isa. Thank you.
There's expected to be a last-minute rush on the Queensland border with the clock ticking on the New South Wales lockout. Let's go live to reporter Nick Kelly now at the Coolangatta checkpoint. It's too late for me, Nick.
Yeah, good morning, Carl. Things are certainly starting to build here, but we are being warned to expect things to get much worse as Queenslanders try to rush home to beat that 1 o'clock deadline tomorrow morning. Now, yesterday we were hearing reports from drivers that there were delays in the cars of around about an hour. We're expecting that to be a little bit worse today, but hearing anecdotally from police that a lot of those queues yesterday were due to confused residents stopping and asking questions about what will happen to them when those stricter lockdowns come into effect. We've got some answers this morning, a list of postcodes of what classifies as a border resident. That stretches down as far as Brunswick Heads on the far north coast. But certainly, Carl, if you are a Queenslander and you are in New South Wales and somehow missed all these warnings, now is the time to come home.
Righto, I'm on my way.
Leaving right now.
Thanks, Nick.
Communities across New South Wales are on tenterhooks with several newly detected COVID carriers, possibly exposing thousands of people when they visited high traffic spots like shopping centres, restaurants, and in one case, a football match. Today's Gabrielle Boyd joins us now in the studio. And Gabby, this could be really bad.
It certainly could, Ali. There's a number of areas which have authorities really concerned here in New South Wales. I want to run you through those. The most severe warning is issued to the inner city area. Everyone who might have visited a restaurant named Jambo Jambo and Glebe on July 31st is being told they need to self-isolate for 14 days and get tested immediately. It's linked to a man who's gone bar hopping. He visited Jambo Jambo, the Everly Hotel in Redfern, Warren View Hotel, Mary's in the city, Cubby's Kitchen, Burrow Bar and also Woolworths in Marrickville. Now let's move to alerts in Sydney's south and southwest. You need to be on high alert for signs of COVID-19 if you are in Westfield Penrith Plaza or Barbecue City Buffet in Bankstown on the 1st of August. In southwest Sydney, Master Hotpot and Mounties have been marked as problem locations. Finally, details about an outbreak in Newcastle. A man attending seven different venues over the weekend, including the A-League game at Hunter's Stadium with possible coronavirus symptoms. Positive people walking around our streets. New South Wales health authorities are doubling down on their message about wearing masks in public. Ali?
Thanks, Gabby.
A new virus case in South Australia has sent health authorities into overdrive with more than 1,000 people forced to self-isolate as a precaution. A woman in her 20s who attends Theberton Senior College has tested positive to coronavirus, sending 70 close contacts into hotel quarantine for 14 days. The college cluster has now grown to 5, with the school shut indefinitely.